Project-based learning is a learning method in which students identify a real-world problem and develop a solution for it. Students develop new knowledge and skills by working on a bigger project. Hi guys, I'm Lucy from BookWidgets, and in this video I'm going to show you 9 good educational tools that might help you with setting up a project-based learning experience. I've divided these apps into 3 different categories, and the first one is apps for teachers to plan classroom projects. Let's get started. The first tool is Trello. This app gives you a view on all the projects or little tasks that need to be done. Trello lets you create boards with lists. You can name the list, add different cards to the list, and add documents, links, comments, checklists, and so on to the cards. You can invite your fellow teachers to the boards with the lists so they can add cards as well. Trello is perfect for setting up project-based learning activities and will keep you organized while planning them. Next up, the Planner widget from BookWidgets. This allows you to build a checklist that students have to follow during the complete project. It gives them a clear structure to follow, though they have to go through it independently or in little groups. As a teacher, you can add voice recordings with instructions, and you can add even more interactive exercises to each step of the planner. Those exercises can be worksheets, checklists, surveys, flashcards, videos, and much more. The last tool for this category is Slack. In many cases, a project-based learning activity is covered throughout different courses, so you'll have to find a way to communicate effectively with your fellow teachers. With Slack, communication gets much easier. You're chatting live with other teachers, getting everything done quicker. In the second category, I'll show you apps for students to collaborate on classroom projects. My number one tool for this is Google Docs. With Google Docs, students can work together in the same document at the same time from another device. No more sending files back and forth, no more figuring out which file was the latest. The next app is Lucidchart. Students can create plenty of different diagrams such as flowcharts, mind maps, wireframes, and much more. Of course, students can collaborate with others and work on diagrams together in real time. Padlet, our next tool, is a live pin board that makes working together on classroom projects easier. You can use Padlet in many ways as a teacher and as a student. You could set up a Padlet board for every group of students working on a project. They can brainstorm on topics and pin ideas and comment on them. They can add links, images, videos, and so on. Sharing thoughts has never been so easy. As a teacher, you can follow up on their ideas and progress instantly and give feedback in the Padlet post comments. In the last category, I'll show you apps for students to create content when doing project-based learning. Are your students very talkative? Then why not let them create a podcast series for a school project? Spice things up and use Spreaker to record a new podcast episode or to stream live. Looks like an amazing digital project. Storybird is the next app. Storybird combines creative tools for writing, reading, and storytelling in educational settings. Students can make their own story, and it makes students of all ages feel like real authors and bring their fantasy to life. Just let your students summarize their journey throughout the project and let them write it down in Storybird. And last but not least, Zoom. Let your students host a webinar by giving a presentation about their project. With Zoom, you can invite parents to join in on the webinar. Involving your parents is always a good idea. You're keeping them up to date about this classroom project, and they can see what their children accomplished. That's it. I have 10 more apps for you via the link in the description. Make sure to give it a quick look and subscribe.